All right, what's up YouTubers? It is Keith. Thanks again for tuning in. This topic of this video is going to be on, should I conceal carry in a messenger bag, backpack, purse, and things like that. And my opinion, just straight out the gate, no. Definitely not. I would never advocate anyone to conceal carry a firearm in a backpack, in a purse, if you're a woman. Or a man. No, I would never advocate that. And for the obvious reasons, it's not attached to your person. It can easily be removed. And for that reason, I would say no. No, I would never advocate that. It's basically common sense. Now, about 10 years ago, about 10 years ago, maybe 8 years ago, 8 to 10 years ago, the market for concealed carry was growing. People were getting their license, especially in the last 5 years. People have been taking the concealed carry courses to obtain a concealed carry permit. And because of the obvious climb in the concealed carry license being distributed throughout the United States of America, it put a new idea to the people making consumer products, being backpacks, laptop carrying bags, purses. And so because of that, it was a marketing scheme. It was a huge marketing scheme. Anybody who's ever been in a course, an actual course, you're never drawing from a concealed carry bag. That's just not practical. I don't care what you say. It isn't practical. And common sense will tell you that if someone's going to approach you just walking down the street, the only reason they're going to approach you is because they want something from you, okay? From your bag. If you have a bag, whatever it is, especially if it's a laptop bag or if it looks like a messenger bag, something that carries maybe a laptop, maybe a tablet, maybe a computer, things of value, is a purse. Okay, these are things that a perpetrator is going to go after. That's what they're going to, intentions of approaching you with threat to retrieve that, to rob you. That's why you conceal carry, to prevent certain measures from taking place. Now, people selling these conceal carry bags and everything like that, they know that. But because of the demand on people getting their license, they found a niche that people might think they need, when in actuality, they don't. And it's dangerous, because if you have your firearm in a bag, usually someone will take that bag. Sometimes, depending on where the area is and the amount of time they have, they can skirmish through that bag in front of you. Now, if they come across a firearm in your bag, they can use that on you or your loved ones or the people you're with or passerbyers or maybe a police, law enforcement comes to get the situation under control. They see a threat and they want to come. That person can take that firearm, which is registered under you, and use it against law enforcement. So there's just a plethora of things that can go wrong, and it's not responsible. As a gun owner, you're supposed to have your weapon, your firearm, on you at all times within reach. Now, if your book bag or notebook or something gets stolen, forget about it. Then you have to go through the headaches of trying to retrieve that firearm, making a police report, doing all these things when it could have been avoided had that firearm been on your person. So do I advocate all these concealed carry bags and messenger bags that have this cool pocket where you can get in your firearm fast? No, that's ridiculous. Robberies happen in seconds. People think that you have all this time to retrieve your firearm. That's just not proven. Okay, we're talking about basic statistics. If you're in a crowded area, people can snatch your bag right off your back, right off your shoulder, and it's gone. And you're you're now facing to retrieve that with a person who has a firearm in their possession now. So it's just not smart. But that was a void, a marketing void that designers made to fill that niche, and it started selling, and people started buying it. Now, for women in particular, purses, carrying your firearm in your purse, is downright foolish, because that's exactly what a perpetrator or someone who's trying to steal something for you is going to go for, your purse. And now you have your firearm. You ever see a woman trying to struggle to get her purse back from someone who has it? When you have a purse on your shoulder, it's very vulnerable. You don't have your hands on it, and it's very vulnerable position. Trust me, I've done exercises where a purse was being removed from someone's shoulder, and as they're struggling, the individual got their firearm from a concealed from its concealed part on their person, from a holster. Now, you may say, well, if it comes down to what I'm wearing, right? If I'm wearing a skirt, or if I'm wearing a pantsuit, or whatever, it's harder to conceal with where those options. Now, I want to tell you right now that that is a complete and utterly false statement, and that's just a complete a foolish and uneducated statement, because, believe it or not, women actually have more carry options than men do. That's a fact. They have bras that have retention straps and holsters built in them. They have integrated what do you call those, not stockings, but like a girdle, not a girdle, but they have more options to conceal than men do. That's a fact. Men can conceal on a chest rig, on a holster rig, or somewhere on their belt, whatever position you carry, appendix, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, whatever the case may be. Women, however, have extra body parts that can conceal firearms extremely effective. So to say that, well, I'm a woman and it's hard to conceal is an uneducated statement, because women have more carry options than men do. There's girdle carry holsters. There's, like I said, bras that have accommodations to carry small firearms. So that's just an excuse. And they say, well, it's not comfortable. Well, carrying a firearm isn't going to be comfortable. I don't care what you say. I've been carrying for years now, and it's never comfortable, okay? It's not meant to be comfortable. It's a utilitarian tool. So, but going back to the bags and stuff like that, don't buy into it. Don't buy it because it's selling and it's the new thing, and oh, look, it's got this compartment where you can get to it quickly. No, you can't. You can't get to it quickly. You can't. Especially when you're trying to struggle to retrieve that shoulder bag or messenger bag or backpack from someone trying to take it from you. And if you don't believe me, then get your high-speed backpack with this conceal carry option, compartment, whatever it is that you bought it thinking that it would be a great tool, an asset to you. Put it on like you're wearing it and walking down the street, and have a friend or someone try and grab that from you, and you empty your magazine and make sure your weapon's safe, there isn't any round in there, and try and retrieve your weapon while it's dry, and try and retrieve it and place a dry fire on that person. And I guarantee you, it's going to take a lot longer than if you have your firearm on you. Now, what I'm saying is train with it, meaning your weapon isn't loaded, it's completely empty, there isn't anything in the chamber. You did a complete safety check and made sure the weapon was cleared and there wasn't any magazine in there. And like I said, store that weapon as you would carry it if it was loaded and locked and cocked and ready to rock, and have someone struggle and try and remove that from you. Two things are going to happen. Maybe three. I'm going to say three things are going to happen by this exercise. One, the first thing you're going to realize is that it ain't easy. It is not easy, and it's not a good idea. Two, you're not going to retrieve anything because they're going to grab it off you so slick that you're not going to have time to even know it. Now, this is you're anticipating someone going to take it off your shoulder. You're doing this exercise for that intention. So you already have your mindset knowing that it's coming. That's not how robberies take place. Robberies take place when you don't expect it. That's why it's a robbery, okay? So with that being said and that in mind, do this exercise. Have someone, hey, I'm gonna have my backpack on, I'm gonna have a messenger bag, and I'm gonna have my emptied firearm in there, and I'm gonna try and retrieve it and put an effective dry fire on target. So that's gonna happen. One, you're gonna realize right off the bat that it isn't very accessible and quick as you think it is. Two, you might not even be able to retrieve your firearm because your backpack, bag, purse, whatever you're carrying with your firearm in it is gonna be gone before you can even, and out of reach before you can even retrieve it to try and defend yourself and your property. Or three, you're gonna be struggling so long with this person that you're gonna have two hands on your bag, two hands on your purse, two hands on your messenger bag, whatever. And the perpetrator possibly could only have one free hand, which they can inflict effective blows to you, right? Or they can have a knife or a blunt object, or they could have something else to defend them to getting what they want. So I strongly urge all you people out there who are buying all these concealed carry bags and all these purses and carrying your firearm that's going to offend your life and your property in something that is not attached to you. Now, I have a Voodoo Tactical concealed carry fanny pack that I strongly suggest as considering that as an alternative means of carrying your firearm if you have your concealed carry permit. And the reason being is because it's attached to you. You wear it basically like a belt or a tool belt. It's not easy to remove. It's on your waist. It's attached to you. Keep in mind, when you have your firearm holstered in a regular belt, it's the same thing. Your holster is attached to your belt. A fanny pack utilizes a strap like a belt to go around your waist. And the fanny pack that I have, the Voodoo Tactical fanny pack, is a rip-away, open, easy, accessible to your firearm. And it's intuitive. That's what my point is. It's very intuitive. Someone can't just come by and snatch it off you. It's up front by your junk where you can see it at all times. It's not on your shoulder. It's not on your waist. It's not on your back. That's just stupid. That's stupid. In the Philippines, if you ever go to the Philippines, they'll tell you to keep your backpack in the front of you if you're going to go in heavily dense populated shopping districts, because theft is so rampant in the Philippines and in Asia alone, you know, in these areas. And so when you have your backpack on your back, you can't keep your eyes on it. You can't see it at all times. And when you're in a dense populated area where it's congested, people are all up on each other, rubbing and bumping into each other, that's when theft happens at a high rate. So obviously you're in a third world country or you're somewhere else out of the United States, unless you're carrying, that's a whole different setting. But here in the stateside, you have to keep that mentality. Just because you're not in the Philippines or in Asia, you're in the streets of Los Angeles, because that's just, they can't carry, but in any other urban area, okay, and you have a backpack on, if it's on your back, it's accessible to easier to everyone else other than yourself. And that's where I'm getting at. That's the whole purpose of this video, is that I strongly urge all of y'all who are considering, who have your license, that you're going to consider carrying your firearm in your backpack or in a purse. That's just, it's not intuitive to retrieve that. It's just not. And if you take a course, go ahead, take a course. That's why you see all these courses, these pistol defense classes, and whether it's 1, 2, 3 or advanced or whatever it is, you're drawing from a holstered firearm. Your firearm is holstered. Excuse me. So there's a reason why. And people struggle with that. People struggle with drawing from a holster and placing rounds on target. And that's from a vantage point where it's easier for the shooter. That's why you never see people going through these courses with backpacks and all these high speed concealed carry bags. It's not intuitive. It's not a defensive standpoint. It's not you being smarter than your a person who's a potential threat to you. It's not smart. So you always want to be aware of your surroundings and your environment, but also prepare for the fight. And if you prepare for a fight, you'll have your firearm easily accessible, because that's what it's for, you guys. Putting your firearm in a backpack or a messenger bag or a laptop carrier bag is stupid. It's straight up stupid, and it's bad teaching on all these individual, all these YouTube warriors out here making videos like it's a good idea. It's a stupid idea, and it's going to get people killed, and it's going to have people lose their firearm. And now they're not going to be having a firearm to defend themselves because they bought some $180 messenger bag that their firearm was in. So now they don't have a firearm to defend themselves or their household. So it was a big marketing scheme, and it's still thriving right now. People are still buying these bags with this hook and loop holster that sticks to the side of it. That's just foolish. I've bought bags in the past, packs that have had that option, but I never carried my firearm like that. Never. So don't do it. Train like you fight, okay? If you see a boxer training to fight, he's not going to throw his gloves in his backpack, or, you know what I'm saying? It's just, you know, the military doesn't go on patrols with their rifle in their back, in their backpack. Or it's just, come on, you guys. Use your common sense. You guys are smart. Don't do it. Ladies, don't put your firearm in your purse. Do not put your firearm in your purse. Because if I was a robber, if I was a perpetrator, that would be the first thing I'd go after. I'm not going to go after you because you have a cool belt on, or because you have awesome sneakers, or because you have, you know what I'm saying? So use your brain. If you have to defend yourself, you have to think like an enemy. Think, what would I go after if I saw you? That's why you got to be a Mr. Gray. You have to be stealth, you know. Don't be, you know what I mean? Don't look like you got valuables in a bag, you know what I mean? I mean, yeah, we're all about fashion, and you want to be about fashion. But when it comes to protecting yourself and your person, don't carry your firearm in something that can easily be removed and used against you, more importantly. So I hope you like this quick video, you guys. Don't buy into the marketing. It's just another, you know, people have been selling backpacks for decades and decades. And how do you start a whole new line? How do you make it new again? Well, you look at the trends. Okay, concealed carry permit holders are getting up. Let's make a concealed carry permit option for people, you know, that have license. Backpacks. People use backpacks all the time. It's college kids. Purses. Women have purses all the time. So they make that option for people, and they buy it because it's just bait on a little hook. You guys, don't fall for it. Stick with what is effective. That's what it comes down to. That's exactly what it comes down to. Give you a real quick example: brooms, like a household broom. It's been in that design for thousands of years, hundreds of years. A broom, a simple broom. Have you seen that change its ergonomics? No, because it works effectively like that. Don't change it. But yet they're selling. They're still selling. I bet you have a broom in your house or your apartment right now. That's because it works. Okay? Don't try and reinvent the wheel. Keep it stupid simple. And carry in a holster. Carry in a chest rig or a shoulder rig. Don't carry in a purse. Don't carry in a backpack. Don't do that. You're making a very bad choice. If you're a woman, if you're a man who has a wife who has her concealed carry permit, don't let her carry her firearm in a purse. Okay? So, hope you like this video, you guys. Take care. Thanks for all the continued love and support. I will see you in the next video. Please like, share, and subscribe. If you're not a subscriber of mine, I appreciate it. And I will see you guys in the next video. Take care. God bless.